So here's a story that some of you might be familiar with. It involves a character by the name of Ammar al-Duhani. It's a very interesting encounter that takes place in the time of Imam al-Sadiq in the city of Kufa. Ammar al-Duhani is summoned to court to provide a testimony. The judge presiding over that particular case was the supreme judge appointed by the Umayyad regime at the time, a man known as Ibn Abi Layla. Now, Ibn Abi Layla was a notoriously anti-Shia, and he despised every iota of the followers of the Ahlul Bayt. So when Ammar al-Duhani goes to court, Ibn Abi Layla refuses to accept his testimony, and he says to him, قُمْ يَا عَمَّارْ فَقَدْ عَرَفْنَاكَ لَا تُقْبَلْ شَهَادَتُكَ. Get up and leave my court because your testimony is not accepted. And then he provides a justification, if you like, which in a way was a bombshell as far as Ammar al-Duhani was concerned. He says to him, لِأَنَّكَ رَافِضِي, because you are a Rafidhi, that's why your testimony cannot be accepted in this court. So Ammar gets up, and the hadith says, قَامَ وَقَدْ ارْتَعَدَتْ فَرَائِصُهُ. He was trembling, he was shaking. وَاسْتَفْرَغَهُ الْبُكَاءَ. And he began crying and weeping in a vigorous manner. Ibn Abi Layla looks at him and he says to him, أَنْتَ رَجُلٌ مِّنْ أَهْلِ الْعِلْمِ. Ammar, I've known you to be a man of knowledge, a man who reports narrations. إِنْ كَانَ يَسُوءُكَ أَنْ يُقَالَ لَكَ رَافِضِي. If you're insulted by being labeled a Rafidhi, فَتَبَرَّأْ مِنَ الرَّفْضِ فَأَنْتَ مِنْ إِخْوَانِنَا, then all you have to do is relinquish your Rafidhi faith and you'll be one of us, you'll be a brother to us. فَقَالَ لَهُ عَمَّارْ يَا هَذَا مَا ذَهَبْتُ وَاللَّهِ حَيْثُ ذَهَبْتُ. I am not crying for the reason that you stated, because I feel left out. Rather, I'm crying for two reasons. I'm crying for me, and I'm crying for you. The reason I'm crying for me, فَإِنَّكَ نَسَبْتَنِي إِلَىٰ رُتْبَةٍ شَرِيفَةٍ لَسْتُ مِنْ أَهْلِهَا. Listen to this. This is because you gave me a title that I don't deserve. You claim that I'm a Rafidhi? وَيْحَكْ. Woe unto you. لَقَدْ حَدَّثَنِي الصَّادِقُ عَلَيْهِ السَّلَامُ أَنَّ أَوَّلَ مَنْ سُمِّيَ الرَّفَضَ السَّحَرَةُ الَّذِينَ لَمَّا شَهِدُوا آية موسى في عصاه آمنوا به واتبعوا. My master Imam al-Sadiq has told me that the first people to receive this title, which in the eyes of the oppressors is a pejorative, but in our eyes it's an honorary distinction, the first to be called Rafidha were the sorcerers of the Pharaoh, who once they witnessed the sign of Moses and how his Cain turned into a giant serpent which gobbled up all the magic. They then opted to follow Moses. وَرَفَضُوا أَمْرَ فِرْعَوْنَ. They rejected the command of Fir'aun, and that's why they were called the rejectors, the Rafidah. So I cry because you've given me a title that I just don't deserve. I know deep down I'm not a Rafidah. And then he says to him, وَإِنَّمَا بَكَيْتُ عَلَىٰ نَفْسِي. I cried for me, خَشِيتُ أَنْ يَطَّلِعَ اللَّهُ عَزَّ وَجَلَّ عَلَىٰ قَلْبِي. I'm afraid that God will look into my heart. God knows more about me than I know about myself. He is closer to me than my jugular vein. He knows my sins and He knows my wrongdoings and He knows about my transgressions. God will say to me, Ammar says, Ya Ammar, akunta rafidhan lil abatil. O Ammar, were you truly a rejecter of falsehoods? Amilan bit ta'ati kama qala lak. Were you truly obedient to me and my commandments just as you were labeled? And if God then forgives me, then me wearing the title of rejector, the title of Rafidhi, will bring my levels down if I'm forgiven. And if I'm not, وموجبا لشديد العقاب علي إن ناقشني. I will then deserve the severest of punishments if God chooses to do so. إلا أن يتداركني موالي بشفاعتهم. Unless and except if my masters intercede for me, if they step in, the Ahlul Bayt, to provide me with their intercession. That is my only hope of salvation and redemption. And then Ammar says, وَأَمَّا بُكَاءِ عَلَيْكِ. And the reason I cry for you is because of the enormity of the lie that you have just committed. لِعِظَمِ كِذْبِكَ فِي تَسْمِيَتِي بِغَيْرِ إِسْمِي. You have given me a title that I don't deserve, and what a big lie that is. وَشَفَقَتِ الشَّدِيدَةُ عَلَيْكَ مِنْ عَذَابِ اللَّهِ. And I sympathize for the great chastisement and punishment that you now deserve for giving me a title that I don't deserve. A title that you perceive to be the worst pejorative, the worst insult. I cry out of sympathy for you. كيف يصبر بدنك على عذاب على عذاب كلمتك هذه. How will your body persevere? How will you bear the punishment and the pain? Now people understand this hadith the wrong way. They think it's a license to call ourselves Rafidhis and rejectors. They even put a cute little Ra character in front of their Facebook and Twitter and Instagram profiles, you know, in a tongue-in-cheek kind of way, that I'm a Shia. And while I admire the sentiment, this story is telling us to do the exact opposite. Ammar al-Duhani cries because he says, now I see that people think of me as a follower of Imam al-Sadiq, when in fact, I am not. Nothing about me says I'm a Shia. Nothing about me says I reject falsehood and sin. Not the way I look, not the way I speak. Nothing about me resembles Ja'far al-Sadiq, the ever truthful master of the righteous ones. So then the Imam praises Ammar. Listen to what he says. The Imam says, لو أن على عمار من الذنوب ما هو أعظم من السماوات والأرضين. If Ammar was carrying sins greater than the heavens and the earth, لمحيت عنه بهذه الكلمات. Those sins would be wiped clean for saying those words and making those statements in the presence of the judge. وَإِنَّهَا لَتَزِيدُ فِي حَسَنَاتِهِ عَنْدَ رَبِّهِ. And those words that he made, that declaration, will increase his rewards in the eyes of God to the point that even the smallest grain will be amplified and exaggerated until it becomes greater than the entire earth by a factor of 1,000. The Imam praises Ammar, but for what exactly? Because Ammar disavowed the Imam from his sins and wrongdoings. In other words, and I want you to think about this carefully, as it's a very delicate and rather nuanced understanding of the story. He is honored by Imam al-Sadiq for having effectively vindicated the Imam by seeing himself as farthest from being a Ja'fari. He's almost screaming, who am I to be a Rafidhi? Who am I to be a follower of Imam al-Sadiq? Now, brothers and sisters, we cry for the fact that the shrines of our imams have no domes to shade them. We cry because their graves are devoid of visitors. We cry for the desecration to which the formerly glorious shrines of Baqi'a have been subjected. And we should. But you know what? For once, let us cry for an even greater travesty of justice. Let's cry for something that's even more soul-screeching. You know what that is? كونوا دعاة الناس بغير ألسنتكم. Our followers, the Imam says, stop talking for once. Let's stop using words which for the most part are nothing but empty rhetoric. Let's, albeit for once in our lives, opt for actions instead of words. اتقوا الله وكونوا زينا لنا ولا تكونوا شينا علينا. جروا إلينا كل مودة وادفعوا عنا كل قبيح. How shameful that our Imam even has to ask. Imam al-Hadi is saying, be pious. Then he says, be a source of honor for us. Don't be a sign of shame for your imams. It's disgraceful. Wallahi, it's disgraceful. Let's make an also feeble attempt to realize that it's shameful and disgraceful to hear that a business run by an atheist is more honest than that of a Muslim. It's disgusting to have retailers panic when they see a conspicuously Muslim man or woman walk into their store and send a sales agent to ensure they don't steal something. It's disgraceful that in an attempt to absolve the Prophet of Islam from our misdeeds and immoralities, there are now those who say Islam is one thing, Muslims another. Don't judge Islam by the actions of Muslims. They will say this. By God, it's shameful that even we've begun to believe this, as if to succumb to this scandalous and reprehensible reality. Islam is one thing, Muslims another. What does Imam al-Sadiq want from you and I? He says, be pious, be observant, be honest, be trustworthy. And when you do that, people will say, هَذَا أَدَبُ جَعْفَرْ فَيَسُرُّنِي ذَلِكَ. When you're good, people will say, here's a Shia, and that pleases me, the Imam says. But when you don't, when we assume ourselves to be above God's law, that despicable, inflated sense of entitlement and self-conceit, that because we are Muslim or because we are Shia, we are taking the fast lane straight into paradise. When that happens, the Imam says, يَقُولُونَ هَذَا أَدَبُ جَعْفَرْ فَيَسُوءُنِي ذَلِكَ. You want to see how disgusting, deplorable and bad Islam is? Just take a good look at Muslims. And that hurts me, the Imam says. That's what we should be crying about. That's what we should be crying about, not just Baqiyah.
That's what we should be crying about, not just Baqiyah.